take a step back, cause it's any setback. It was one of the greatest fights in boxing history. Many people consider it fight of the century. Diego Corrales against Castillo. I'm here with Joe Goosen, who's working the corner of Diego Corrales in that legendary fight. First of all, Joe, I got to tell you this. I put a picture of Diego Corrales on the internet the other day, and within seconds, hundreds of people gave it a thumbs up.
Really? What picture was it?
I'll show it to you. It's him lifting his hands up in the air.
After which victory?
That I'm not sure.
Well, maybe I'll be able to help you.
But until I find it, what can you tell me? Why do so many people consider that fight as the greatest fight ever, or one of the greatest fights ever?
You know, it's funny. I got a couple calls after the Rios Alvarado fight, and I, you know, of course the announcers have tried to make the.
225 people gave it a thumbs up, and everybody said rest in peace.
Yeah.
Well, we'll get back to that.
Okay.
That's a great shot, though. You know, and I know the announcers have, you know, tried to make the comparison that, you know, the Rios Alvarado fight, well, you know, it's comparable. And then I get a few people that, you know, may take a little bit of issue with that. I don't, because both those guys are putting their all out and they're, you know, they're really showing a lot of courage and technique and determination. And they're at the top of their game, so I would never want to take anything. But yeah, those comparisons are always made. They were made this weekend about Corrales Castillo. Well, at least they have in the past. I'm sure it was this weekend. But, you know, the bottom line is that, you know, people do call me about it still. And they go, well, you know, they might compare that fight to the Corrales Castillo fight, but you know they feel that there is, you know, no comparison in terms of, you know, the drama. And I think that's really where the difference is in the Corrales Castillo fight, besides the fact that they were really five-star technicians. You know, they were very capable of what they did. And then the drama of it all, you know.
Castillo dropping Corrales twice and Corrales getting back up off that, knocking out.
Yeah. It was a real tug of war, though, from the first round on. It was, you know, Diego may have had the early rounds and then Castillo mounted a counterattack and a body attack in the mid rounds and then started swinging back Diego's way again. And then it swung back to Castillo when he dropped Diego in the 10th round twice. So it really was a back and forth fight.
The fight's on the internet.
Yeah.
Would you tell people, go watch the fight if you haven't seen it, and then maybe you can compare? Because people like to compare stuff without really studying. Or refresh your memory if you did see it.
Yeah, no, for sure. Listen, somebody asked me, I have certain clients here at the gym that sign up and take lessons and what have you. And they asked me, what's a good fight for me to watch? I said, well, tell you the truth, I would recommend the Castillo-Corrales fight because it's riveting. It's really technique at its finest. It's bravery at its utmost. And it's, you know, drama like you couldn't write in a movie. So it really had all the elements. And I do recommend it. Just remind me, this weekend, did they make reference to Castillo Corrales again this weekend?
I'm not sure if they meant. I didn't
they
hear
did
nothing.
The first time.
Did they really? Yeah, but yeah, the first fight.
Yeah, the first fight.
I didn't hear anything on the second fight.
No, but I know they were trying to compare it to the Corrales.
I don't think there's no comparison with that fight.
Well, listen, in all fairness, what I say, you know, these guys are at the top of the game. They're giving it their all. There's certainly a lot to be said about how much they put into it and their technique and what have you and their great training. So, yeah, that being said, I still believe, though, that it's going to be a while before somebody tops that Castillo-Corrales fight.
What do you guys remember from Diego Corrales? Obviously, he passed away in an automobile accident. He was in a motorcycle.
Oh. I just remember that he has some great stories all the time. Very exciting stories.
Like what? Can you share one?
Surfing with sharks.
What jungles?
Jungles of Panama.
Right.
It was just, he was very entertaining.
You know what? Diego was an adventurous guy. And, you know, he loved to travel. And, you know, he loved to mix it up with the high life a little bit, too. You know, he wasn't just some, you know, guy from the Lower East End that just hung out. Well, no, he enjoyed the good life, too.
He was like Richard Hanson from Britney Records.
No, right. No, he was a daring guy. He'd jump out of planes. He'd swim with the sharks. He did all that stuff. He loved to cook.
He hung out with Ricky.
Yeah, he did actually with...
I'm trying to, you know, what is it? You trying to link that up with swimming with the sharks?
No, he used to come to my house and he used to get home cooked meals. Him and Jack.
Yeah.
We'll go out. He would fly me out to Vegas. He was a great guy, you know.
Yeah, look, you know, I've often said when he left my house after meeting my family for the first time, my wife actually said, so normal.
Yeah.
You know,
we would eat your wife's pasta, lasagna. And her spaghetti.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Diego would love that.
So, you know, a couple times a week he'd come over for dinner and she'd cook. And
if he didn't pass away, how far would he have gone in his career?
Well, look, I mean, he won 4 world championships. That's pretty damn far. He fought one of the greatest fights that will ever be fought. You know, he is kind of a legendary status right now. He'll certainly be a Hall of Fame fighter. You know, when you ask where could he have gone, I mean, yeah, could he have sustained it and done more? Absolutely. But, you know, he certainly reached great heights in the short time that he was around, and we do miss him. We talk about him all the time. And pardon?
After the first fight, when was the second fight scheduled?
Well, let's just put it this way. Second fight, third fight, whatever fight, after that first fight, they shouldn't have seen each other for a year.
Yeah, that was...
Okay, minimum.
We went to the hospital right after, Joe, what is the picture?
Oh, well...
Well, picture of what?
Well, let's just put it this way, you know, when you're in some brutal body battles like they were, you can have a little bit of blood in the urine. This was an inordinate amount.
Yeah.
To the extreme, and the color was as, you know, vivid as you would ever want to imagine. In fact, the doctor did a double take when he saw it, and it was literally filled up like that. It was quite shocking.
It was like tomato, like a sangria.
Well, you're putting it, I'm trying to put it mildly, you're putting it bluntly, so, but the point being, though, is that it's not unusual to have blood in the urine after a match, and it will dissipate and go away quickly, which this did as well. It just happened to be at that particular time. It was a lot, and it was very, very vivid, you know, color. And even the doctor did a double take when the nurse said, "Oh, doctor, here's the urine." He went, "Oh, great." And he went, "What?" It was, yeah.
So my last question: what would you guys tell Diego Corrales fans if they're watching?
Well, if Diego Corrales fans are watching, I'm sure they're thinking the same thing we do.
He was a warrior.
As we're talking about him, he was one of the great guys. He was a loved guy. People loved him because
they still do.
His personality, the way he was, you know, himself.
He knew how to verbalize his thoughts. You know, he was pretty eloquent about what he had to say, and he was a deeper thinker than you might have given him credit for. And ultimately, what the fans love is that whatever he said on the outside of the ring, he backed up on the inside of the ring. He was one of those guys that you say will die for you. That guy would literally
die for you.
Would die for you instead of he would not want you to stop a fight. Any fight.
Yeah.
He'd rather go out on a shield, as they say.
There you have it, Diego Corrales will be missed. Joe Goosen, Ricky Funes, right here in Venice, PS3Point.com, and Mike Sipak reporting.